Morning, American School, Warsaw. Students' questions. Was there ever a moment when you gave up and were like, I'm done, there is no more chance? And what was it like? There were times that I was discouraged, but I wouldn't say gave up, because the main reason I stayed, one of the main reasons, was the young people, Anita and Janvier, and they were both alive there every morning. I think probably if they would have been killed, then that could have been a reality that I was like, this is, or if, you know, the kids at the orphanage have been slaughtered, then those might have been times I might have said, I'm done, I'm out of here. But when I got discouraged, I always thought about the kids. I thought about Damask, Asiqua, Dawson, people who were courageously working and pushing forward, Philip Guyard at the Red Cross, and you kept going. So, yeah. How did you meet Emmanuel? Emmanuel, survivor, courageous young man. A young lady went to Rwanda to make a film about orphans in Rwanda and their journey, how they're recovering. And she met Emmanuel in that. And then Emmanuel's best friend was one of the kids at Kasimba Orphanage that I was bringing food and water to. And so when this young lady, college student, was making the film, and she met Emmanuel, she just saw the great value that Emmanuel brought to the film, made him a partner. And then his friend, Scott Moody Johnson, told him about me and how I used to bring water to the orphanage. And so I met Emmanuel. He picked me up at the airport in Omaha several years ago, gave me this bear hug that I'll never forget. One of those hugs where, you know, somebody hugs and then you sort of lighten up your grip, but they don't lighten up, so you re-grip again. And no, so glad we met. And that was through our good friend Scott Moody Johnson. So, do you have nightmares? It's been a couple of years, probably about 2 or 3 years. I did have them for many, many years. They're terrible. But I would always think about my Rwandan friends and how are they getting through their nightmares. But as time goes on, the nightmares became a little less intense. And like I said, I think it's probably been about 2 years. After going through so much, how do you see your life now? Well, I'm really grateful for the opportunity to just live, to be able to travel and share stories about Rwanda's recovery, to share stories about the people during the genocide who were trying to stand up against the genocide. So I see my life now, I mean, obviously a gift. That might sound like a cliche, but no, it's there's no doubt that that we're capable of much more than we ever imagined possible. While people are capable of great evil, we're capable of incredible, the people of Rwanda demonstrating incredible recovery resilience. And so I'm optimistic. There's still some hard questions that I don't, you know the answer to, but I do see my life now as, you know, optimistic. I felt I had a purpose before, but even now those purposes are really clear about building bridges, the power of stories to inspire service, and service empowering stories. So what was your most terrifying experience that made you realize you might not come home? Boy, mortars falling around the house was pretty terrifying. The whole roof is shaking. Windows are vibrating. One time a window busted from the sound waves of a big gun that was fighting. They'd set up near our house to fight against the rebels. So I think being in the middle of that warfare on a regular basis was just really made you realize you might not survive. And then, had the back window shot out of my car one time, machine gun fire. I had just gotten out of the car and there's bullet holes in the headrest. Back window shot out. There were many times at the orphanage when we were surrounded by the militia, whether it was bombs, rockets, whether it was machine gun fire, whether it was specific threats against me. I think it just took a couple weeks, and then you're like, you know, you might not get out. But I think what keeps that fear from paralyzing you is just that you have a focus, you have a mission, and then you can you can do, like I said, a lot more than you ever thought you could do. I think that's mostly it. So thanks for your question, guys. Take care.